What's going on, everybody? Welcome to a new video, and in this one, I'm going to be going over what I think is one of the most underrated plays out of the ever-popular Gun Bunch formation, and that is Inside Cross. Now, yeah, I'm in the West Coast playbook right now, which obviously is one of the more popular playbooks in the game, but you can find this play in a lot of other playbooks, as you can see on the right side of the screen right there. That's all of the offensive playbooks that contain this play, and there's two real reasons why I really like this play. The first is that Devin Funchess' C route on the left side, you get a nice short C route, which is the same route that makes plays like corner strike and PA post so good. And so that's obviously a great route. And then out of the backfield, you have Christian McCaffrey on pretty much a speed out slash in route. And so some people call it like a dragon route. That's a route that does a really good job, especially against man-to-man coverage, but it can be really good against zone coverages as well. And so this is kind of the way I like to set up. This is the stock way the play is set up, and then what I like to do is I'll drag my A receiver, streak my B receiver, and so what this setup kind of gives you is a nice two-level flood on the left side between the drag and the C route. The drag fills in nicely across the field into the flat, and then you have the C route behind it, so it's a nice high-low on the flat zone defender, just like a concept you see a lot out of like PA post. And on the right side, you have a nice three-level flood between the streak, Greg Olsen on the wheel, and then McCaffrey coming out the backfield. So the streak kind of clears out, the wheel hits the sideline, then turns up and kind of gets into that tender spot like a corner route would, and then McCaffrey fills in for the slot. So you kind of have a three-level flood on the right and then a two-level flood on the left. Now, obviously, the weakness of this play is the fact that you're sending five guys out on routes, and so your pass protection can suffer. And so that's just something to keep in mind. There are alternative setups that I'll go over in a little bit. But for this setup, what I like to do is first read the left side of the field, and then I'll go read the right. So snap the ball here. It looks like man-to-man, and this is a great play to beat man-to-man coverage if your opponent's running a lot of man. You're going to get the drag open 9 times out of 10. You're going to get McCaffrey, the dragon route out the backfield open 9 times out of 10 against man-to-man. Pretty much 10 times out of 10, you know, this route out the backfield is going to beat his man and get separation. Right here, you got the drag route, and if I could have waited a little longer, I would have had the C route right there. So you have three routes that just very natively beat man-to-man coverage, and so your opponent, if they want to run man, they're going to have a really tough time trying to slow down this play in particular. Now right here, that's exactly what I'm talking about on the right side of the field. So it looked like a Tampa 2 setup right there, but that Greg Olsen route does a great job of pulling the flat zones down the field. So right here, you can see the two deep shell kind of forming. Trey Wayne's out here in a flat zone, but Greg Olsen with the wheel route pulls him down the sideline, and it gives space for Christian McCaffrey to come underneath, and he gets out there so quickly because of that cut on his route. He really bursts across the field and basically becomes a drag route, and so you can really see the three-level flood filling in nicely here, and it works just like you would expect it to. On the left side here, you have the same thing. It's a high-low on this cornerback, Xavier Rhodes. And so in this case, he's in a cloud flat guarding the C route. You would go ahead and you would hit the drag route underneath. So it's just a really, really safe play. And it's, you know, a great mix in, I think, because of the fact that that McCaffrey route really kind of sets it apart from other routes or other plays in this same formation. So once again here, you hit the drag route. Going over the middle of the field, Curtis Samuel trying to turn up field. Once again, just a high-low read. And really, that it's very simple. You know, that's pretty much all this play is just taking what the defense gives you right here man-to-man. Once again, actually ends up running into Terrence Newman there. A little pass interference, but that's Madden sometimes. But this route, even just against random zone coverages, you can quick throw that possession catch, get down, and that's an easy 5 or 6 yards. That's something that your opponent is really going to have to sit in the middle of the field and kind of threaten you to not throw. Right there, McCaffrey kind of got chucked a little bit by Anthony Barr. But you can throw that route very quickly out of the backfield against a lot of different zone coverages, for instance, just right there. So it's great early on, and it's a great, you know, later on in the progression. So there's just a huge window you can throw it, so it just presents problems. Now, another way you can run this play is if you want to kind of have a little more pass protection, you can do something like this where you block Greg Olsen. You don't get the same effect on that right side of the field with that flood. That Olsen route really does a great job of pulling the outside zone defenders downfield to open up McCaffrey. But if you're struggling in pass protection, then this is definitely something that you can go to. It just doesn't really work the same right there as Harrison Smith was able to get to me even whenever I blocked Greg Olsen. But I'll try to show you guys the McCaffrey route on the right side of the field as he gets caught up. And so it's just a little bit, you know, Sendejo was a little more in the area there, only a five-yard gain, as opposed to if Olsen was out on his route, he might have got pulled downfield a little bit further. Now, one last way you can run this play is if your opponent is running a lot of Tampa 2. Something that I like to do is you can motion McCaffrey over to the right side, and what this will do is it'll force the backside cloud flat defender into man-to-man coverage onto Devin Funchess' C route, and so you can really take advantage of the fact that he's going to be in man-to-man, and you can work in that C route, that low pass. It looks very close, but that's a very consistent pass to make. And so that's just a game behavior where if there's no receiving threat on the left side of the field other than this one guy, the cloud flat's going to man-to-man match. And so that's going to open up the C route. So that's good for guys who, you know, if they might be spamming Tampa 2, they might not know about this trick, or, you know, they see Tampa 2 is a popular defense in high levels of play and they just don't understand. So that's definitely a great way to attack somebody who's telegraphing the fact that they're in Tampa 2. But that's pretty much going to be it for this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. As always, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, guys, take it easy.